Every trip is perfect in your head, right? Stellar views, perfect weather, great family time. Yeah, that's how I thought this trip would go too. Just look at how optimistic I am here in the intro.
This weekend, we are trying to beat the heat.
I had no idea how frustrated I would be and how drastically we would need to change our plans. Sometimes it's the plan D-E-F-G that you end up with. And even then, sometimes you just can't catch a break. This is one of those trips.
So here we are. We're starting the trip. If you remember, there's a video that we released on a quick guys trip. This is the spot that we came to camp. So if you remember this view behind me, it's from one of our earlier videos this year. Well, this is where we're starting. We're gonna keep going. So those mountains behind me, we're gonna go up to the top of those and try to find a cooler spot to camp. So let's get going. It's gonna be a lot of fun, beautiful scenery, and some really interesting trails. Let's go.
This route runs along the South Fork of the Boise River before jumping into the mountains. The 101-mile South Fork starts in the Smoky and Soldier Mountains before descending through basalt canyons and joining the Middle Fork at Arrow Rock Dam, eventually emptying into the Snake River. It's part of the watershed that drains Idaho's Sawtooth Mountain Range and part of the Snake River Plain. The drive is scenic and easy, especially if you have a high-clearance four-wheel drive vehicle. However, when it's 100 degrees outside and you're running the air conditioner, it's never a bad idea to stop for gas. The town of Prairie is perched on the backside of the Soldier Mountains and is truly in the middle of nowhere. We almost always stop for gas at the Y Stop General Store when headed through, but today we decided to add some ice cream to the list of essential camping supplies. So yeah, things were going great, and we were just enjoying the drive. At 4,800 feet, the temps were down to 95, so we were making progress. Our final destination was Trinity Mountain, which would bring us up to about 8,000 feet. I was super excited about getting back to Trinity, as it was the first place Kate and I had an overlanding experience together.
We stopped in gas at Prairie, and then from there, we climbed up and over this very, very burned area. And now we're dropping down into a pretty thickly forested valley. And we're gonna drop down, we're gonna cross over this valley, then we're gonna come up the backside of Trinity Mountain. And we're at about 5,700 feet. When we're done, we'll be up between 8,000 and 9,000 feet. And so we've got a lot of climbing to do, but we've gotta get over to that mountain first.
We do have some fire bans, but the area we're going to isn't in a fire ban area. But it's just been so dry and so hot, there's real danger. So I can't help but think about that a little bit as we, come into camp.
It wasn't until we got to the final turnoff to climb up the backside of the mountain that we realized our first mistake. The road was closed.
Well, this says the road's closed between November 10th and July 15th. Today is July 2nd. You know, this really stinks because it's taken about 3 hours to get here. Regroup.
Okay, so there is nothing to do. This is not a great spot. I had high hope maybe we could just camp here, but it's not that great. So there's nothing to do but backtrack. So we're just gonna start heading down the road. I'm gonna look at the guy and see what other offshoots we might wanna go explore and find a new site. And this is the adventure. We're gonna find something great, I know it.
I was incredibly frustrated by the stupid mistake I'd made, but Kate reminded me that we always land on our feet, so we backtracked. And what we found was a very lonely dirt road with no tracks on it that led to a bit of a clearing. It was flat, there was plenty of space, and while it wasn't the top of Trinity Mountain, we could at least see the top of Trinity Mountain, and all in all, it was a pretty good fallback. This was our plan B, but you know what? Sometimes these mistakes or mishaps just make the journey all that much more memorable. We had everything we needed, and most importantly, we had each other to enjoy the evening with. So, as long as nothing else went wrong on this trip, it was turning out to be pretty great.
Okay, veggie burgers. We tried this out a while ago and it went really well, so we decided to try it again.
Yeah, except these are Beyond Burgers, not a veggie burger. I'm not sure I know what the difference is.
Some form of non-meat.
It's a non-meat version of a burger, which is less mess at camp, which I love. easily packable, and it's pretty good for easy first night.
And these are like cauliflower tater tots?
Cauliflower tots.
I mean,
for cauliflower, they're pretty good. I mean,
there it is.
I like cauliflower soup.
The kids will eat it. I'll eat it too. Okay, so plan B.
So plan B may be better than plan A.
And why, saying, and why is that?
We are on a very lonely road in the middle of a place most people never A, travel, or B, stop. And we've got an amazing, amazing view.
Yeah, it's not bad. Not bad at all. We could be a lot worse than this.
So the cool thing about this campsite is that it must have been like an old logging turnaround point for logging trucks or a staging point or something, because it looks like it's been dug out, but it's really flat and it's really kind of like sandy, and there's no vegetation around, so it makes us feel way, way better by having a campfire without worrying about a stray ember starting a forest fire. That's really, really nice.
I'm usually the first one up at camp, but that also means I get to have the first cup of coffee. It's one of my favorite morning routines. Making the coffee this morning helped give me time to think about how we might still be able to get to the top of Trinity Mountain. I used my Gaia GPS to create a new route to the top. I was fairly certain that if we could just approach the mountain from the front side, we could still get up to Trinity.
Good morning. So we are just enjoying some coffee and quiet time at camp before we have our breakfast and then pack up and go find our next adventure. We think we're going to take a different route. We ended up, you know, having a closed road last night, and so we're just going to take it all in stride and do something different. It's going to be great.
Don't get it right the first time, try again, right? So off we went, back down to the valley floor so we could swing around and go up the front of the mountain.
So we try to keep a clean camp and make sure that we pack out everything that we pack in, and then when we're out going from place to place, we keep an eye out on camp sites that have trash service. So what we do is always put your trash in a designated trash service bin. Don't put it in the downtown trash bin. Don't put it in a fast food parking lot. Just find a place that has trash service, like a campground, and put it there.
So we have taken a long way around. We gassed up in Pine, and it was about 90 degrees in Pine at 11:30, about 4,000 feet. And so we decided we're going back up. We're going up to Trinity Lakes because that's about 8,000 feet. And so we think that 4,000 feet of elevation difference will make it significantly cooler. So at the very least, we're gonna go up there and have lunch. We'll look around to see if we're going to stay the night up there. If not, maybe we'll head back down to the Boise River, one of the forks, to like go sit in the river for the rest of the afternoon. So for right now, we're climbing.
Except that the road was closed again.
Okay, plan C. Plan C is to drive up to Rocky Bar in Atlanta, gain some elevation, and maybe find a creek or a river. And so this is a little bit less known for us, this track, where we're gonna go, and that's part of the adventure, is just exploring and finding new places.
I sound really optimistic here, but I wasn't. I was pissed, and I felt stupid, again. But we'd never been up to these particular mountains, and Kate's family had a cabin up this way when she was a kid, So we embraced the setback and moved forward, and what we found was a beautiful drive. We hit Rocky Bar, an old mining settlement, and decided to keep climbing. Sometimes you just have a feeling that the road you're on has something really great waiting for you. And this was one of those roads, so we just went.
Well, I am really glad we chose to come up this road because these views are world class. Look at that, everybody.
On the way up, we found markers and monuments along the road, remembering the bravery and determination of the pioneers that settled this area. It was not for the faint of heart. We came upon this plaque dedicated to Peg Leg Annie, whose feet froze off back in 1896, walking the same trail we were on. Wow! Imagine living in these mountains in the winter without being able to order a warm coat from Patagonia. Our hunches were right on. This trail led us to a beautiful spot. It was actually better than we could have imagined. As we looked around at the purple wildflowers, felt the cool air, and took in the view. We'd finally found our spot on top of a mountain. Except for one thing. Thunderstorms.
So we stopped for lunch at this really great little perch, about 7,800 feet, just under 8,000 feet. And it's so great. But you see behind me, there's some thunderclouds forming. Just when it's this hot, thunderclouds, thunderstorms are pretty common in the afternoons, and so we would rather not be on top of a mountain when a thunderstorm rolls through. So we're gonna pack it up and keep heading down the hill.
I think we were on to plan E now, which was to drive down to the Boise River, find a camping spot, and get in the water to stay cool. We figured if we couldn't have cold air, we might as well have cold water. Luckily, it was a really fun drive with beautiful views all the way down. After we reached the river and started looking for campsites, we realized something that was really important.
Okay, so we went to the top of the mountain to get cool, and there was a thunderstorm. So then we came down and we thought, let's go get in the river. Well, we came down to the river and there weren't very many great campsites. And when we got close to the river, we realized that it's only gonna get down to like 85 degrees tonight. And so it's 100 during the day, 85 at night, and we just said, no. There's no reason we need to do this. We're gonna enjoy the rest of this drive on this beautiful river, go back home, get in the air conditioning, run a movie, and eat a pizza. You know what? That's still a pretty good Saturday night. So I'm considering this a win.
It was a win, but not because of the pizza. We did so many things wrong on this trip. We're experienced overlanders and we made mistakes like forgetting to read signs and checking for road closures. But just because we struck out over and over and over again doesn't mean we lost. It was a win. Because without those mistakes, if we would have just stayed home to begin with, we would have ended the weekend just as glazed over as we went into it. Instead, we lived, we tried, we reached, and we're stronger for it. So here's my tip of the hat to those who try. The trying is actually the point. And if the worst thing that happens is you take a long, winding road that brings you back home, that's not a mistake. That's a trip worth taking.